In this problem, we have a gallon jug filled partially with water. We take a measurement of the mass of the jug and end up with a mass of 2.937 kilograms. Now we place the jug on a laminated wooden surface and pull the jug using a force gauge. We record the force just before the jug moves. We want to find the coefficient of static friction for the jug on the laminated wooden surface. Now let's put everything into a diagram so we can derive the formula for solving for the coefficient of static friction. So we have a gallon jug partially filled with water resting on a laminated wooden surface. It is exerting a force straight down, which is the mass times the acceleration due to gravity. The surface it is resting on is pushing back with an equal and opposite force, which is the normal force. The normal force multiplied times the coefficient of friction equals the force that has to be overcome when pulling the gallon jug. This force will be referred to as the friction loss. To get the jug to move, the pull force must be greater than the friction loss. However, we are interested in the force needed right before the jug begins to move. This means that the friction loss minus the pull force must equal zero. Rearranging the formulas, we have that the friction loss equals the pull force, which equals the normal force times the coefficient of static friction. We can further rearrange the formula to get the minimum pull force to cancel out the friction loss over the normal force being equal to the coefficient of static friction. This is the definition of what the coefficient of static friction is. I have listed on this slide the experimental pull force just before the jug began to move. I then took the average of this data. After plugging in our numbers into the coefficient of static friction formula, we get a coefficient of static friction of 0.078. Now in theory, the coefficient of static friction should not change if the weight of the object changes. Let's see if this is true experimentally. I filled the jug till it had a total mass of 3.819 kilograms. I then pulled the jug 5 times and took the average force just before the jug started to move. I then plugged that average into a formula and got a coefficient of static friction of 0.08. This is about a 2% difference from the measurement with a jug with mass of 2.937 kilograms. This is probably due to experimental error, so the theory holds up to the experiment. Now to finish things off, let's tie down what we learned in the previous video. Find coefficient of static friction when given the angle the object starts to slide down incline to this video. I tilted the surface up at an angle and got an angle just before the object started to slide of 4.7 degrees. Recall from the video that the tangent of the angle is equal to the coefficient of static friction. Plugging in our angle, we get a coefficient of static friction of 0.082. This leaves us with a 4% difference from the average of the first two examples. Being that I only took one measurement, this experimental error might be due to the small sample size. I am pretty happy with how close all the results are to each other. Any variance is likely due to experimental error. That concludes this video. Hopefully I've earned a like, share, or subscription. If you enjoyed this video, you may enjoy one of these videos. Thank you for watching.